learned vocabulary words. Level A, lesson 2. Let's start. Wow, first word. We brush our teeth with this. Now we're not talking about the toothbrush here. We're not talking about it, but we're talking about the part right there. What is it? What is it called? And what does it mean? We brush our teeth. Chop, 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 like that, right? We brush our teeth with this. And we don't have this, so we can't brush. So what is it called? It's called toothpaste. Toothpaste means kind of like a liquid. That is kind of like, it's mixed liquid and solid together to make a kind of like a liquid that can be in our teeth to brush them. Okay, so it can make our teeth be fresh. Now the next word we have here, we have yellow. The fruit that is yellow, a yellow fruit. It has seeds here, but it tastes sour. Ooh, it doesn't taste kind of like sweetly, right? It tastes sour. Okay, so it's kind of fruit, but it tastes very sour. Usually you put it in olives first, so make it into a little bit more sour. And what is it called? It's called lemon. Lemon. Sometimes we can make a lot of great things by lemon. We can put it inside food to make it feel nicer, to make it taste nicer. The next one, that it's kind of like a liquid that girls, these liquids only girls use to smell nice. They use to smell nice. Oh, when they put it in their body, right? They feel kind of like flowers. So what is it called? What is it? This is a liquid. It is perfume. Perfume is kind of like a liquid that girls use. They put it over the body, right? And then, it smells wonderful. Sometimes there are perfume for boys too, right? It is a perfume and people use perfume to kind of like to use it and to make their body to be a lot more nicer. Smell a lot more wonderful, right? So perfume, the liquid that girls use. We cook food in this, so this is a liquid, right? Liquid, this liquid usually has the color yellow. We don't drink it, it's bad when we drink it. But we use it to heat the pan, the hot pan or the hot pot to cook or to fry it or to heat something, right? It's called oiled. Oiled, okay? Oiled. So oil, a liquid that we use in cooking, it helps us to fry things and to heat things up, okay? Oiled, remember, we use it in cooking. We have cooking oils and oils, right? So when we're using it in cooking, use cooking oils, don't use a kind of like common oil. So now this is a strong line. It's kind of like a strong kind of line that we use to tie things. We use to tie to a kind of like to tie things together to make it strong, right? And it won't be easy to be untied, right? So what is it? It's our rope. This is kind of like the rope is very strong and we use to tie things together. Okay, a rope usually has a lot of layers of leaves or something. Now this is soap, and soap is something that you wash with. So You see, if your hand is dirty, then you use a little bit of soap and put on your hand, or maybe you wash your face, right? With it, right? So then this soap, it said that 100% vegetal. So vegetal is not the language in or English, right? It means 100% of vegetable. It is made out from vegetable, 100% of vegetable, okay? So it's called soap, 100% vegetal. Vegetal is kind of like vegetable, right? Okay, so soap, something that you wash with. So that makes something to be a lot more cleaner, okay? Soap, something that you wash, okay? Now, someday if you're very tired after a whole day you're working, you feel like, oh, I just want to sleep, I just want to take a nap. So we will eat to get energy again. We'll eat so we have energy after a tired day. We just want to lie in the bed, right? So what will we do? We would eat something, and that's called food. So we have two main kinds of food. We have foods that are from plants, right? These are called vegetables and fruit. And next is meat. Meat is something. Or fish, maybe meat or fish or pork, right? Something like that, yeah? So we have two parts, plants and meats. And or meals, right? Next, we have a plant. So this is a new kind of plant. It's a plant with a fresh smell. It smells fresh. It smells very nice and it tastes red. It tastes great and tastes fresh, right? So then this is the word called what? It's called mint, okay? So let's see the word mint coming out. This is mint. Did you ever hear about mint ice cream or mint hot chocolate chocolate? Yeah, it tastes wonderful. I love it. What about you? And sometimes people put mints in food. So that is kind of like it makes the food taste fresh. It tastes more better, right? To taste better, a lot more better, okay? So this is mint, a plant with a fresh smell, remember. It helps you to be fresh. And we've talked about lemon before. Lemon can help us to make many things. So what's this? What is this? A drink with a lemon flavor. So what is it called? When we make it, we add in lemon, a little bit water, sugar, right? It tastes very yummy, very delicious. So what is it? It's called lemonade. It's lemonade. If you read fastly, then it will sound like lemonade, okay? So lemonade is kind of like a drink. It's a liquid and it tastes wonderful. And in hot days, we drink lemonade and it tastes wonderful for people, right? So lemonade. Okay, and the next word we have here. This is a long yellow vegetable that has a green skin. And it is long, like this. Yellow is yellow right here, but right there is green, we're talking right there. It is a kind of vegetable too, that it has a green skin. It has a green skin, right? It has a green leaves around it. That would peel it, like we're peeling a banana, but it's not a banana, right? And we have small pieces. pieces of corn here. It is very small, right? When we're looking together, we look at one whole bag corn, right? We see that there are lots of them. We eat them. I'm hungry now. Okay? Now, this is the next word we have here. It is an exercise. It is a sport in which the player that plays this sport, this exercise, will jump. They will need a rope. And they will jump over a rope when they're moving the drop up and down like this. They need to move fastly, jump up to jump over a rope. Right? That is called what? It's called jump ropes, right? Jump rope. You jump over a rope. So this is the rope of this girl. She's jumping up and down to be over a rope. It's called jump rope or jump over a rope, okay? And the last word and our words that we have here is a game. It is a game that we need or strength very much. We need our legs or strength. And this is a game which both two teams that have the same amount of players. So if this team has 8 players, then that team needs to have 8 players too. Hold a rope. Hold a strong rope and pull. They'll pull to their side, and our team will pull to the side too, against each other. Now pull against each other. It's called tug of war. Tug of war. Tug of war is a game that pull against each two others. They want the rope to be in their team, right? But that side they want to be the side where it's winner too. So they need to pull a lot, right? So the game is called tug of war. Tug of war, right? Okay, so see you next time.